Hello everyone, and welcome to a new series. For this series, I'm going to be playing BeeHappy, which is a mod pack through Minecraft. I found it on Twitch, and it's based off of bees, mostly the forestry mod, but then it adds in other mods such as extra bees, and I think magic bees is another one. Basically, it's a sky block, and you go through the quests. And so, as we can see here, we have this quest book. In the quest book, it says, "Hi, my name is John. I'll be your guide for this mod pack, and I'll try to help you reach the end of the sky block map. First, this map is all about bees. Quests are concerned with bees and their products. You'll have a lot to do by yourself before starting bees, though. Hint, do the basics chapter first. Bees are great for honey, but not only honey. Iron, tin, copper, gold, redstone, diamonds! You can do whatever you want to get the resources, but you might get bitten sometimes. Yeah, they hurt, but don't worry. A special suit will be delivered in one quest. I hope you enjoy ultra bee farming. Shall we start?" So if we click to start, as you can see, there's 75 quests in total. 49 are unlocked right now. If you were to play this on a server, you could play with a party, and then when each of you, like if one person completes the quests, you all complete it. You can also do hardcore mode, which limits the amount of lives you have. And your reputation, I'm not sure what that's about. I haven't learned about that yet. So chapter 1, it said to start with back to basics. So there's two quests in total. So the first one is the welcome chest. You probably saw a chest. That's your welcome chest. You have 2 patterns and 9 seeds. Good stuff. But like always, you have to punch wood so you can get materials to make that axe. And then, well, I'm not going to ruin this prize, but maybe Wala or Hollow Inventory will. Use it to explore every single block, well, 3 of them in particular. Another hint, use the jungle sapling to get wood to plant something, maybe cocoa beans? So this quest wants us to get 4 oak wood, and then we get a stencil table, tool station, part builder, crafting station, watering can, and a jungle sapling. And then we get to choose between coal and toast. So this is the welcome chest that it was talking about. We have an axe head, a tool rod pattern, and seeds. And then, from playing this in the past, I haven't ever completed it, but I've gotten about halfway through it. I know that there's 3 carpenter safes. This one has a carpenter, some glass, metal princess, and metal's drone. And then, we need to break this tree. And this will give us the 4 wood that we need for that quest. Plus an extra piece. Oh, an extra 2 pieces. And then I also know down here was a carpenter's safe, so we have 8 dirt, 8 saplings, 8 bread, rocky princess, and a rocky drone. Might as well pick up that extra sapling that fell. And then the last one is over here. So we have crop sticks, more glass, forest princess, and forest drone. Now I don't really need to keep them separate, so I'm just gonna continue with that. Now go back into the quest book. So we hand in these items, so we'll manually submit them, which means it takes them away. I'm gonna choose coal because there isn't much room, so I'm not really going to be running, so I don't think I'll be losing my food that fast. So as you see, when you complete that, you get the stencil table, the tool station, the part builder. I always switch them. And then the normal crafting station. Oh no. Alright, so I cheated in the part builder because that was a bad start, and I'm terrible with things falling off. So, even though this might be cheating, I'm going to go, since it's available, NEI options, inventory, and then we want to change global to world, utility mode, and then we'll have magnet mode and the delete option. So now when I turn magnet mode on, any items that fall, that's alright, we won't cheat the wood back in. Most items that fall, like if it falls over there, it'll get sucked into me. So now, we're just gonna plant some trees. I believe twerking's not in this. Oh, that's right, we gotta use the watering can. So in order to use the watering can, we need to fill it, and then it goes away from being empty. Alright, we got our first tree, and it's a big one. Great. So now we just need to get rid... Oh no. Need to get all this wood chopped. I believe that vein miner is in this. I'm not sure if you have to... Maybe it's only when you have a tool. It must be set to that. So why don't we go over here? We'll go into our quest book again because it was talking about an axe. So let's see here. Okay, no, that doesn't go into that. So we'll just make the axe. So I know for tinkers, you have to take... Okay, it already gave us the patterns, so we just need to add in the wood. So that would be here. I think it's logs, or planks, they're called. So we'll just get some planks here. Right there. So there's a wooden axe head, and then we need a tool rod. And then in the tool station, we just add them, and then there we go. We have a hatchet. I guess I should put some of this stuff back in here in case I fall off or something happens. I like that they give you a second quest book, because that is very useful. So now let's see. If I hold down the grave key, yes, okay. And then you see that's what magnet mode does. It kind of just helps to bring all the items that would have fallen to you. Some think it's cheating. I mean, I don't really think it's cheating because it's already in the game. If I added it myself, I would say it is, but since you can't even choose whether you have cheats on or off, I'd say it's meant to be used. Alright, so now it's night. Let's go into the quest book. So, missing carpenter. So, preparing this made me nervous. I'm missing one carpenter, and I hope you can help me find it. Remember that I said you might use Wayla to help find three things? Yeah, I wasn't joking. Without my carpenter, I'm doomed. The reward is very good, so you can see the importance of this machine for me. Okay, so the carpenter was one thing that we found inside of the carpenter's chests, or safes. I think they're carpenter safes. So we can just manually submit. Oh wait, I put it in the chest. Take it out. And we'll give it to him. Okay, and then we get two solar panel threes, a hardened energy cell, and 12 hardened flux ducts. And we get to pick one of these. I'm gonna go with, I guess the small cobblestone design. Okay, now, as you can see, we get more quests here, and some of them are already unlocked. Let's see, Cobble Trouble. Now you have three platforms, but I know that breeding bees is not possible in a small space, so I decided to give you the opportunity of a lifetime. I give you a lava fabricator and a bucket. Pretty good deal, right? In exchange, could I have some bread? I'm starving. So, he wants to eat bread, which... we found in the chest. So if we give him the eat bread, we get a lava fabricator, a bucket, and I'm going to pick 32 more of that same small cobblestone. Okay, now it says heating up. Now you have wood and cobblestone. What you really need is machines. With the reward from this quest, you can get gravel and sand and then use it to get some glass. This will be very useful in the future to get resources. So this one, we do not have to hand in the items, they just detect it from our inventory, and since we already had 16 wood, it automatically completed it for us. So we get a pulverizer, a redstone furnace, and a sawmill, all basic. Now over here we have the builder's wand. So, you are short on space and you will have a lot of apiaries to deal with. You might find a wand that can build for you will be helpful. I might have one handy. Let me find out. So for this we need to hand in 16 cobblestone, which does not work with the chiseled cobblestone, so we have to make 16. So, what we want to do, it's already nighttime, so we're not going to be able to get any energy. But, for now, we could put these down and put our energy cell here. Now, for those of you who have never used this before, you have to configure it. So, if you shift left click, or right click, on the middle of this, it'll clear all of them. Orange means that it goes out, it sends power. And blue means it comes in. So we want both sides to be input because we want solar panel energy to go into this hardened cell. Alright, so while we're waiting for it to be daytime, I'm just going to put the machines in here in case I fall off. The bucket and the lava fabricator. I should probably make a bigger chest. And we'll just store all of these things in there for now. The apples, I guess, I'll keep with me. And while I'm waiting for it to become daytime, I'll chop down some trees, and then I'll bring you back once it's daytime. Okay, as you can see, it's turning daytime. We have the energy cell filling up here. I didn't get too much wood, but I got enough. And now what we can do is go ahead and get our machines. We need the flux duct, lava fabricator, and the bucket. We're also going to need cobblestone because we're going to have to make one of the old school cobblestone generators. So we'll put that right up there because I don't want the machines to fall off. And we need to configure the outputs here. So we need the outside face here to output, and we also need the top to output energy. And now this is connected. So now the flux duct, we want to do, we'll put the sawmill up there, we'll put the redstone furnace down here, and we'll put the pulverizer right here. And then we'll put the lava fabricator right here. And then as that gets energy, it's going to create lava, which is going to take a little bit. So in the meantime, we'll take our cobblestone, we'll make our little platform here. It doesn't have to look pretty, I'm not worried about it looking pretty at this point. Because this is just temporary anyway. Once we get the cobblestone going with the igneous extruder, we won't need this. Well, I guess since I messed up and I don't have a pickaxe, I might as well just leave that right there. So we want to put right here, we want a hole, and then we want the lava there. Hopefully I have enough blocks. I think I do. And then in the space between, I'll just fill this in. Might as well just fill that in so that it's equal. Okay, so then what we'll do is we'll put the water right here and it'll flow down. Oh wait, do we need this out one more? I think we might. Alright, so we're gonna make this. So I already made the tool binding pattern and the pickaxe head. We're gonna use the same tool rod. Oh wait, we don't have any cobblestone, so okay, now we have our tree, so we'll add the cocoa beans on here, let that grow. We're almost there with the lava. The sawmill, we use wood in it. I'm not sure what it's used for. I've never used this before. Oh, okay, it gives you more planks and sawdust. And sawdust can be used to make paper, sponge. I'll just wait for this to finish up and then I'll be back with you guys. Okay, so as you can see, we have the lava filled up here. So now all you have to do is click on it with the bucket and then we get the lava. So now we can go ahead, create some cobblestone. And now, I think I have enough, so I'm going to go ahead and make a pickaxe with the tinkers out of stone, and then I'll come back. Okay, so I went ahead and I collected some cobblestone, and I created the pickaxe, and then I repaired it. And then, now we're going to go into this quest book here. This one we already had because we already had all the meadows, the forest, and the rocky princesses. So I just completed that, got all the seeds. That's how I got the cocoa beans before. Next we have the basics of bees. So if you don't know how to play, I can help you and try to teach you how this works. First, let's see the house of bees. This is an industrial apiary from Gendistry. You can put your princess and drones and it will just breed the bees. Sometimes you will get some combs and some spare bees, but pay attention, some bees don't produce spare bees. They have fertility equals to 1. You can change that with some machines. We will talk about that in the next quest. So we already had the wood, we didn't need to hand it in, so we'll get this apiary. I think this is a good place to end off. We'll come back and complete some more quests next time. And we'll work on getting more things with our machines and our cocoa beans here. I don't know what these are for, but it said to grow them. So thank you so much for watching the first part of the BeeHappy series, and I will see you next time. Bye, guys.